first, I'm going to give you your cheaters back.
Yeah.
All right. Scotch whiskey. We're back to Scotch whiskey. Are you done? Busting things? Okay.
Baby wants a new spin. Baby wants a broken heart.
Okay. Here we go. All
right. We're back, and it's day.
Check the bottle.
10.
Yeah.
Wow, we're that far in.
10th of December.
Ooh.
10th of December. So we're back to Scotch today. Getting into a Highland Scotch.
Yes.
Yeah, why don't you go ahead and we'll try to speed these up a little bit.
Okay.
Multitask, you go ahead and do the little pour and stuff. So today we have Glenmorangie, the Nectar d'Ur.
That sounds great.
Like as in Christian Dior. 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 So this is a Highland Scotch. We got so good at recycling that we don't have any of the empty bottles left, but do have the package to show you. So Glenmorangie is a classic Highland Scotch whiskey. Kind of continuing in with our finishings this year that we've been doing, like port, etc. So this is continuing along with those. Oh, you're getting aggressive. Wine cask finishes. So this one is finished in a Sauternes wine cask. Tell them what that is, Anne.
I have no idea. It's probably made in a certain region in France. That will be my guess.
Sounds good. I'm not a wine guy, so
no.
Don't know if that's right or wrong. But anyways, so a little bit about Glenmorangie. So Glenmorangie is one of the classic quintessential Scotch producers from
Scotland.
Very good.
Cool.
One of the things they're known for is they have the tallest pot stills in Scotland.
Huh.
Yeah.
Does that matter?
Well, great question, Anne.
Thanks.
Yeah. We didn't even plan
I'm
that.
I'm trying.
So, a pot still, and I'm going to try and be fast here. So, pot still.
You have, pot still distillation, you have reflux. Reflux distillation typically means, like, it goes up, you hit it with some, like, cool temperatures, like water around the column, and it drops the vapor back down. The vapor condenses, drop back down as vapor's going up. So you're getting, like, this constant interaction of the vapor and the liquid distillate dropping back down, so it refines the spirit. With a column, it's just this big pot or kettle and a big line arm that goes out the top. So as the vapor rises up, as it loses energy, it kind of cools down, and it drops back down through, but there's nothing really there to cool it and make it drop down. So as you lengthen or heighten the still, it needs more energy to push that vapor all the way up over to where the line arm, gotta get my hand back down here, the line arm turns, and then as the vapor goes up and it condenses, then it drops down and is collected. So as it's taller, what in theory that means is more of the distillate drops back down, you get more natural reflux of the vapors and the spirit, the distillate as it goes up over, so therefore it should create a bit of a softer distillation or distillate.
So does softer then mean not as sharp? When you taste it?
Yeah.
Or not?
Some would say it doesn't carry as much flavor over, but usually that's not a problem with a pot still. Like, so you can go ahead and start nosing. Okay. But this one, I believe it's a 12-year-old, and maybe it's not 12 years old anymore. I wish I had the bottle that they could set on the bottle. But I'm pretty sure it's a 12-year-old that's initially aged in used oak bourbon casks, and then it's finished in a Sauternes wine cask. So what do you get on the nose, Anne?
Some honey. Ooh. Some wood. But like cherry. A cherry wood.
Cherry?
Yeah. No?
Well, I mean, you get what you get.
Yeah. Some vanilla just now.
Yeah. I'm kind of getting like a lime, like a key lime pie. So that lime with the graham crackery, sugary crust, probably from the malt. Definitely getting some orange peel in there.
Yeah.
Ooh. Coconut. I've only ever gotten coconut in green spot before, but It's very soft on the nose. Very.
Yeah.
Even.
A little bit. Which is why I think it's hard to pull things out. Oh, I just got a bunch of vanilla right there.
It has that definite like scotch, heathery, not so much sulfuric like a Macallan, but there is that, for lack of a better way, putting like a heathery,
yes,
earthy,
yep,
maltiness in there.
I get that first, and then it sweetens out at the end. All right. Ready?
Yep. Just a typical Highland Scotch on the front side. Lots of spice, white pepper, ginger. And I'm not a big ginger fan, but I think it's ginger.
Yeah.
You got ginger? Yeah, you're a ginger person.
I'm a ginger person, yeah.
Nutmeg. It's like Christmas cake.
Yeah, it is, very much. I'm having a hard time. I get a little bit of honey. But definitely some spice. Maybe cinnamon. Smell, when I bring it up, it smells more like... It's cinnamon when I drink it, but nutmeg when I pull it up to my nose. So maybe that.
The flavor is way different than the nose. Like, the nose was very soft, very inviting.
Yeah.
That's spicy.
It is, especially in the back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was not expecting that.
No, but it's good. I kind of like that.
Go ahead.
No, it's kind of like it's soft on the palate and then kind of, I don't know if revs up is the right word or not, but it kind of matures or gets more, more flavor as you drink it.
And I'm going back to the nose now. I'm picking up like some brown sugar, like graham cracker. Yeah, it's weird how tame the nose is compared to the palate. Yeah. Like a lot of places say this is a quintessential scotch to go after. To me, on the palate, it's just, I don't know, it's like a regular Highland Scotch. I think the cool thing about it, why I'm glad we tried it, is... the difference between, to me, the palate and the nose.
Yes. There's a big jump for me between those two.
Where some of you all are at, but... on the finish, a little more... It's a little lemony. You know, I'm not a big lemon fan, so... Yeah. Where is it? So, horsepower in this, 46 horsepower, so 92 proof. I do think I read that this one does add coloring. So E150, a little caramel coloring to it, which I, to me, be nice if they just left it au natural, like I am.
Yeah.
but, if you want to spruce it up a little bit and, juice your whiskey a little bit like some of you do with your beards, go for it. Some of us don't mind it, let it roll. Price point on this, so I guess this is where it kind of tips it for me. I think there's better Highland Scotches out there. This was $68, and I think I got a couple bucks on sale. I think it was probably $72 regular around us.
Yeah.
But, I'd much rather have, a Klein Leash 14. You can usually find that for $50 to $60, and I just think it's a better Highland Scotch to me. But I really do like... I like to be surprised sometimes by what it noses and what it tastes and how different those are. Right. So for me, that was kind of cool. I don't know that I'd buy this one again and stick it on the shelf, but
I agree. It was good. Yeah. Good to try.
All right, so you may
some
be able
folks
to,
might
yeah.
really like it
yeah.
too.
Yeah. You may be able to see in the back we've got our favorites out there after day 10. We've kind of put the empty bottles there. They're probably really easy to see with nothing in them and just white glass. So, Anne, does this jump in front of Bowman's for you?
It does not.
No. And I think I'm still riding with Cobegan.
All right.
Yeah. So, shout out today.
Shout out is Montana Mike.
Yeah. So, Montana Mike, we got to give him couple more seconds other than that. So Mike, second year with us this year, Mike sent in an extra hundy. Easy, buddy. I know you're excited about Montana Mike too, but this is Bozeman. I think you can see him in there. See you, bud. Bozeman, Montana. That must have been why he came up here. We're talking about Montana.
Yeah, when you said his name.
Yeah, we totally missed that. Well, his name's not Montana.
Montana, Bozeman. But Bozeman.
Close enough. Yeah, he's a smart dog. So Mike sent an extra hundy for us to buy Christmas presents for the kids and families around here. So Mike, thank you very much for that. And on top of that, Mike sent us a big old box of artisan chocolates from, I believe it was the Parrot
candy store
in Helena, Montana, and they were freaking fabulous.
They were.
So thank you for that too, Mike. Go ahead.
I just gotta jump in there. I think we ate them all already.
Well, you ate them all.
No. Yeah. No, I'm putting it on our daughter.
I'm too sweet. But no. Thanks, Mike. All right, Ann, toast us out.
All right. May your heart stay young, the whiskey be old, the cork loose, and your adventures bold.
See you tomorrow.